Well, good morning and Merry Christmas. This is Saturday, December 25th. So, of course, the scripture I selected is from Luke's Gospel, chapter 2. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord." Well, yesterday, worship services were beautiful. I've not yet looked at the recording, but I hope it came through for our online, and I'm confident it did. But so many things to celebrate, so many little joys within the worship services. Mary and I see you're on, and I appreciate you stepping in to be a lector as well as Jean. And I shared that when folks are reading, I appreciate everybody who reads in church for us, but I especially read it when I know that folks, through their cadence, through their phrasing, through their through their reading, can tell that these texts are so familiar to them that they've read them over and over and over again in their own devotional life, in Bible study, in worship itself. So that adds a lot. I saw Kerry Smith's post about him loving the trumpeter, and certainly as his son, I can understand why they can be so proud of Charlie and the gift of music. I was thinking last night during the service, it might have even been as I was serving them communion, what a gift to have one of the best trumpeters in the state play for you and just add that to the music with Judy on the organ and letting everything loose, the bells, Rebecca playing the recorder, the choir making the extra effort to come to both services, just everybody reaching out, welcoming. We did a little in-between gathering with the choir between the 4 and 7, and I said that this Christmas Eve was much better than the last Christmas Eve where we weren't able to gather. But I still have hopes that next Christmas Eve will even be better. So prayers for safety for everybody, prayers for good decision-making. We are experiencing a first in our household last night. I was thinking this is the first time ever we've had both of our daughters and both of our granddaughters and respective families at home together. So we'll have a wonderful day today. The granddaughters in our household, when our daughters were growing up, we had a rule. I said this wrong yesterday, but we had a rule that the clock had to have a 5 in front of it before you could get us out of bed. And so to have it be 7:30 and still the little one's not, you know, run around the house yet. So that's to be enjoyed. So however you are celebrating your Christmas this day, if it's in a little quiet and solitude and peace, I pray that will be a blessed day. If there's a whole lot of commotion going on, I hope you have joy with that. It was great to see so many people, even though we couldn't visit long last night. It was great to see so many people. It was great to welcome a couple guests. So all in all, just a wonderful worship time. So let me pray. Dear God, on this day, as we celebrate the birth of Jesus, help us to drink in those things that you would have us live through our lives. Help us experience the fruits of the Spirit: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, faithfulness, self-control. Help us to be messengers of your good news. Help us to be peacemakers in those areas where we are able. And help us to enjoy and receive and give thanks for your great love for us. May every person, every creature know this love and then be able to love others. And these things we ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, a couple things on worship tomorrow. We will have both of our services because I'm not a fan of changing worship times because inevitably we throw some people off and they show up at the different times. I don't do a good enough job communicating if we make those changes. So we will have 9 and 11. It will be a service of lessons and carols. There'll be no sermon. So Pastor Josh and I have a little reprieve. The service is very meaningful, and our 9 a.m. service will be available Facebook Live online. In the afternoon at 2 p.m., we will be celebrating the life of Smith Papa Hunter with his memorial service. The family wanted to make sure that word got out that that will be also Facebook Live. Ned offered last night very graciously, and so that will be on Facebook Live 2 p.m. On Sunday afternoon. The family was not discouraging people from coming to worship service, so it is open. It's not a family only, but they wanted to make sure that for anybody that might feel a little bit better watching from home, that the family gives their blessing and encouragement to do whatever you feel is best. So have a blessed day today, and I'll see some of you in person tomorrow, and others be with you online. Bye-bye.